What better way to start it off than Lady Bronco basketball? Kirtland on the court tonight.
And we expect to make another run for state championship.
Because you're right, people are out to take you.
The odds like we usually do and keep working at it. Thank you.
Owens big.
Kirtland was too much. Great move by Nicolette Anderson. Watch this.
Talking about Dexter the Town. I don't know. Maybe they want to play them. Be careful what you pray for. You may get it.
The Kirtland Central girls basketball program is so strong the word dynasty doesn't even fit anymore. Just like the Kirtland fans told me last night, how about them Broncos? For the fourth year in a row, Kirtland finished the season number one in the state. The Lady Broncos won their 12th state title last night. That's second in New Mexico, only to El Dorado's 14. With last night's dramatic win over Pewaukee, this year's squad becomes the first Kirtland team in 10 years to go through a season undefeated. Not bad.
It's going exactly the way we want it to go, and I think just having an undefeated season, state champs coming from behind, couldn't have planned it better.
got you jumping off the deck, shoving into overdrive. I went through the danger zone. I'll take you right through the danger zone. Never say hello to you until you get it on a red light, low, low. You never know what you can do until you get it on the side of you can go.
Kirtland's Sharona Lee is considered one of the best point guards in the state. She started every game on varsity as a freshman and sophomore.
When I first started, I had hopes to play college ball.
Then, one bad decision changed her whole life.
I never in a million years would have thought I'd be a senior in high school and have a kid. I thought that only happens to other people.
Sharona has a 17-month-old son named Rajan. This single mother will be the first to tell you her son isn't a mistake, but her decision to have sex at the age of 16 was.
In some ways, yes, it is a mistake because I was too young to start to have a child and I wasn't even supporting myself. And now I've put my parents in the position to support myself and my son until I can start supporting us.
My first reaction was I was shocked.
We don't advocate kids having kids, but it happens, it happened. We just have to make the best of the situation as it is and hope everything's gonna be okay.
When Sharona steps on this court next month for the state tournament, it may be the last chance she has to play basketball. Now, at face value, it may seem like playing a game is a secondary part of the story, but actually getting back to the court played a big role in Sharona's maturing process.
We haven't really talked about this. I think she felt like she let the team down a little bit. She maybe let herself down, and she wanted to come back and say, okay, I messed up. Now it's time to rectify that if I can, to play my senior year and be part of something special.
Hitting a 15-foot jump shot takes some skill, and getting straight A's in the classroom definitely takes hard work. Sharona is back to doing both, but the toughest and most rewarding task stares her in the face with a smile every morning.
I always have to remember my son and that he has to have a mother to take care of him at home. He can't be out with me and my friends, and so I don't have that ability to go out and be with everybody like a normal teenager would do.
As a basketball player, I wouldn't trade it for any point guard in the state. As a young woman, I'd take her to race. She's something special, and she's an outstanding young person with an infectious smile and a love for life. Someone who is intelligent enough to know that life goes on and you deal with it and make things happen for yourself, because if you don't make things happen for you, they're going to happen to you.
No one knows that better than Sharona. She can't change the decision she made, but getting back on the court and back in the classroom are steps toward educating others not to make the same mistake. She's 6'1", will score at least 20 points a game, and is the best girls high school basketball player in the state. Karen Carlin is not only tops in New Mexico, but in the top 10% of the nation. As a junior, Karen already has heard from schools like Colorado, Western Kentucky, and Texas Tech, all of which are in the top 10 of the national polls right now. Carlin has led the state in scoring and rebounding the past 2 years. Despite being number one in the box scores week in and week out, she doesn't like to think of herself as one of the best.
I try not to try not to get satisfied, because you want to keep improving, and if you get satisfied, then you're not going to keep improving. So I don't want to look at it that way. Everybody on our team contributes, and without them, I couldn't do anything. So
there have been other girls who can score 20-plus points a game, but New Mexico has not seen anyone like Carlin in the past decade. If you chalk up 26 points and 12 rebounds, add another 5 steals and then 3 or 4 block shots, you get your typical Karen Carlin game. Kirtland's Dexter Irvin says she is a coach's dream because she's the total package.
There's a lot of kids that may be 6 foot, 6'1", and can score a lot of points, but how many of them are going to get 3 or 4 blocks, going to get 5 or 6 steals a game? I think the total combination, the total package there, what makes her the player that she is.
Karen's played on the varsity team since she was in the 8th grade. She already helped Kirtland win 2 state titles. Before she graduates, the junior hopes to have a part in 4 state championships. Her teammates don't mind that one player helps take them to the tournament. They say having Karen makes their jobs a lot easier.
When you give her the ball, you know she's going to try her best to put it in the hole. And she really encourages me and pushes me. And I think she's a real inspiration.
It's really neat because I've never played with anybody that tall before. I mean, actually getting to give her the assists and all that stuff from the outside and having her screen, I mean, it's great.
Since day one of this season, Carlin has been the focus of girls basketball in New Mexico. She says she doesn't mind the extra pressure of living up to the billing, but there is more to her life than just basketball. She says if there wasn't, she'd go out of her mind.
Well, I like doing other stuff too. I mean, a lot of my time is spent with basketball. I mean, I do it in the summers and a lot of my extra time, but I like doing other stuff too, just going out with my friends and stuff. I mean, you gotta have something else or you just get tired.
Carlin still has another year and a half to dominate the state in scoring and rebounding. After graduation, she will become one of the few players from the state of New Mexico to move on to a major college and play basketball. Don't be surprised if a couple years from now you turn on the TV and see Karen winning another championship, this one in college. Shiprock rivalry is the biggest basketball attraction in the state of New Mexico. It's standing room only anytime these two schools meet up. Believe it or not, over 4,000 people pack into the gymnasium just to see a girls' high school basketball game. Why?
Because this is probably the only place in the whole United States where you can see competition this good in the Four Corners area. You can only find it here. That's the reason why we come out.
It's the best place to go for basketball entertainment. It's the best competition you can find anywhere.
A typical Kirtland Shiprock girls basketball game, if there is such a thing, is physical, intense, with a great crowd, and usually pretty close. Their last six games against each other were decided by an average of 4 points. No matter what their records are or who the players will be, it's guaranteed to be one of the best games of the year.
I mean, why was Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier a great matchup? Every time they fought, it was close, it was a battle, and you knew it was going to come down to the last round. And it's kind of been that way with Kirtland and Shiprock over the last, I don't know, 5 or 6 years. Each game's an exciting game. It comes down to, you know, a last-minute type of deal very often, and it's very, very competitive.
One of the college coaches here the other day described it, said, I've never seen a phenomenon quite like it, where the kids play so hard, they leave everything out on the floor, and then when the game's all over, they end up hugging each other. You know, so that's what the game's all about.
These two teams will play each other at least twice every year. They usually end up meeting 4 times each season, twice during district, once during the district tournament, and then again in the state finals. Kirtland and Shiprock own 15 of the last 16 state championships. It's no wonder every time they meet, you would think the title is on the line.
It's good to see two teams that are going at it. It's kind of like a state championship every time we meet.
Oh, it's great. I get so hyped up from the crowd. I really enjoy playing them because you know it's going to be a good game.
A Kirtland Shiprock girls basketball game has everything a fan wants to see. Competitive teams playing in a packed gymnasium and the game going down to the wire. It's the hottest ticket in New Mexico, and if you don't get one, you'll miss out on one of the best high school rivalries in the nation.